We need to determine the absolute extrema on the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity of the given function. Now, when determining absolute extrema on an open interval, it is different than determining the absolute extrema on a closed interval. Remember, when the interval is closed, we have to test the function value at the endpoints as well as the critical numbers. But if the interval is open, we can't test the function values at the endpoints. So we'll determine the function values at the critical numbers, but then we'll also have to analyze the end behavior of the function. Remember, an absolute extrema is the greatest function value on an interval, or the least function value on an interval. So let's take a look at a couple situations before we do this problem. If we're trying to determine the absolute extrema for this function here on the left, notice how the function value of negative 1 is the least function value on the entire interval of the function, even though we're considering the function on an open interval. So we would have an absolute min of negative 1 at x equals negative 1 and x equals positive 1. But notice how the relative maximum here is not an absolute maximum because there are function values that are greater than this function value here of 0. So in this case, there's no absolute maximum on this open interval because the function increases without bound to the right and to the left. Looking at the function here on the right, notice how this relative maximum of negative 2 is also an absolute maximum because there are no function values on this open interval that are greater than negative 2. But there is no absolute minimum because this function decreases to the left and decreases to the right without bound. So in this case, we have an absolute max of negative 2 at x equals positive 2, but again, no absolute minimum. Now let's take a look at our example. We'll start by determining the critical numbers of the given function. So we'll find the first derivative, which will be 4x cubed minus 16x, the derivative of 4 is 0. This derivative does exist for all real values of x, so let's go ahead and set it equal to 0 and solve. Greatest common factor here would be 4x, leaving us with x squared minus 4. So this factors again. So we have three critical numbers to consider. X equals 0, x equals negative 2, and x equals positive 2. Now we'll evaluate the function at these three values of x, f of 0, f of negative 2, and f of 2. And we'll go ahead and use the calculator to do this. I've already typed the original function into y1, so we'll go back to the home screen. We're going to press vars, right arrow, enter, enter, and then we'll enter these x values in parentheses. So we have 0, and then vars, right arrow, enter, enter, then we had negative 2, and then we had positive 2. Let's go ahead and record these function values, and then we'll analyze the function to determine if any of these are absolute extrema. Now let's take a look at the graph of our function to determine if any of these function values are absolute extrema. Notice how the function value of negative 20 is the least function value on the open interval of the given function. Therefore, negative 20 is an absolute minimum that occurs at both x equals negative 2 and x equals positive 2. However, even though negative 4 is a relative maximum for this function, it's not an absolute maximum because since the function is increasing to the right and increasing to the left, there are function values greater than negative 4 on this open interval. So there's no absolute maximum, but there is an absolute minimum. Let's go back and record that information. So there was no absolute maximum, but there was an absolute minimum of negative 20 at x equals negative 2 and x equals positive 2.